determine the common ratio R of each geometric sequence. Because we know each sequence is geometric, we can determine the common ratio R using the formula R equals a sub n divided by a sub n minus 1, which means we can select any term in the sequence and divide by the previous term to determine the common ratio R. Looking at the first sequence, let's use the first two terms, or a sub 1 and a sub 2, which indicates we can determine R by dividing a sub 2 by a sub 1, which is equal to negative 1/6 divided by negative 1/2. Notice here we have a complex fraction. Let's write this complex fraction, which is a quotient of two fractions, as a product. Recall dividing by negative 1/2 is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal of negative 2 over 1. Negative 1/6 divided by negative 1/2 is equivalent to negative 1/6 times negative 2 divided by 1. Simplifying before multiplying, notice 6 and 2 share a common factor of 2. There are 3 2s in 6 and 1 2 in 2. This really simplifies to negative 1, though. And a negative times a negative is positive, which indicates the product is positive 1/3. The common ratio R equals 1/3. Number 2, again, we know we have a geometric sequence. To find the common ratio R, let's avoid using the decimals. Let's use a sub 3 and a sub 4. Using a sub 3 and a sub 4, the common ratio R is equal to a sub 4 divided by a sub 3, which is 4 divided by 1, which equals 4. So we can save a lot of time if we select the most convenient terms to determine the common ratio R. Notice if we used a sub 1 and a sub 2, we'd have to divide 0.25 by 0.0625 to determine the common ratio R. If we're using a calculator, probably not a problem, but it's much easier to use a sub 4 divided by a sub 3 to determine R. And now for the last sequence, which again we know is geometric, let's use the first two terms because these are the smallest terms of the sequence, which indicates the common ratio R equals a sub 2 divided by a sub 1, which is 32,768 divided by 4,096. Let's determine the quotient below. To help us get started, let's consider how many 4,000s are in 32,000, which should be 8. So let's try a quotient of 8. 8 times 6 is 48. Perform an exchange with the 4. 8 times 9 is 72, plus 4 is 76. Perform an exchange with the 7. 8 times 0 is 0, plus 7 is 7. And 8 times 4 is 32. And notice the remainder is 0. The quotient is 8, which means the common ratio R equals 8. I hope you found this helpful.